Hey guys, I thought I'd do a little run through of the turn timer. Right here is the main module. As you can see, it's got an LCD screen for displaying stats. It's got a rotary encoder button right here for making selections, and it can support up to 6 players. Here's one of the buttons. It's got this little tactile button on it. It's got an LED to indicate when it's your turn, and it's got this cord that can plug right in. For powering this thing, I'm actually using a standard wall wart right now, but you can get away with a 9-volt battery. I'd probably suggest a rechargeable battery because I'm predicting that this thing will have a 4 to 5 hour runtime on a 9-volt. So here we go, let's plug it in. All right. Right off the bat, we can go ahead and adjust some of the options. Let's go to the options. You can turn sound on or off. You can turn the backlight on or off, and you can adjust what's displayed while you're playing the game. Right now we have it set for displaying player stats. You can also display game stats, or you can do no stats at all. I actually prefer no stats at all, so it's not a distraction from the game, but for the sake of this presentation we're going to do player stats. And you can decide when you want the game time to start. You can choose to have it start on the very first turn, or you can have it choose to start when the device is powered up. You might want to do that if you want to also include setup as your total game time, but we'll just do first turn for this example. All right, let's get ready and let's start a game. First, it's going to ask you for what timer type you'd like to play with. We can play with a relative timer type, which is what we're going to do, or we can also choose a generic countdown timer. We're going to play with a relative timer type, which is going to time you relative to the average time. And we're going to be timing turn time. If you'd like, you can also time game time, but we're timing turn time. And we've got to set up this thing called a time cap. And so in order to explain what a time cap is, I'm going to bring over this little thing I made. All right. So what we've got here is a timeline. This is the average turn length. If you play on this side of the timeline, you're playing faster than the average. If you fall on this side of the timeline, you're playing slower than the average. And we're going to introduce these things we're calling time caps. And so we're going to award a certain point value to these time caps. And let's just go ahead and set them at the extremes for now. Let's say that this is 2 times faster, and this is 2 times slower than the average time. And now we're going to introduce a time buffer. Because if people are playing relatively close to one another, they shouldn't be awarded or docked any points. And so it's up to you to decide what kind of time buffer you'd like. So let's set it at about 20% for the sake of this presentation. So if you fall within the buffer, if you're within 20% of the average turn length, then you're going to be awarded 0 points and you're going to be docked 0 points because you played within the average turn time. If you fall between the buffer and the time cap, you're going to be, on this side of the timeline, you're going to be rewarded points. And it's totally adjustable how many points you're rewarded, and it totally depends on how close you came to this time cap. If you fell on this side of the timeline, you're going to be docked points. So let's get back to the turn timer. All right, so as per the sheet, let's just go ahead and set our time cap at 2 times the average time. And now we're going to introduce the buffer, and we're going to keep it at 20%. And now we have to choose how many maximum reward points. And this is totally dependent on the game you're playing. Obviously, you wouldn't want to play 10 points if the game has a maximum scoring potential of 5 points. I mean, or maybe you do, just play really quickly. What you set this to and what you set the time cap and time buffer to is entirely dictating how quickly people are going to play. So if you really want people to play quick, you can really incentivize the reward. 100 points. Or if you just want people to play leisurely, you can just play with 0 points. But let's go ahead for the sake of this demonstration and play with 10 points. And our maximum penalty, we're going to also keep that at 10 points. Now it's asking us, what do we want to do between rounds? For a lot of games, you can just continue playing after the turn sequence. Otherwise, you can increment if the starting player increments, or you can increment and then pause if you need to do a setup, or you can just pause if you need to set up something after everybody's taken their turn, or you can just completely reset your turns all over again when you're ready for that. So let's go ahead and plug in the buttons, because we're going to play right now with a three-player game. All right. So let's just continue between rounds. Now it's asking us to set the turn order. Press the player buttons. So let's go ahead and set the turn order. Turn order has been set. Are we ready? Yep. All right, we're playing. This player's LED is lit up, and as you can see here on the display, his turn time is clicking away, and let's just assume that he's going to take a 15, let him take a 20 second turn. All right, play has passed to this player, and he plays pretty quick. He's going to take a 7 second turn. Now we got the third player over here, and he is also going to play in 7 seconds. Now it's back to this first player. So as you can see here, we now have stats on his average playing time. We know he plays an average of 20 seconds per turn, but we also know that the game average is currently 12 seconds per turn. So this guy is looking to lose some points, but you know what? He's continuing to play slow. He takes a 25 second turn this turn. And let's just assume, for the sake of demonstration purposes, that the game is now over. Any player on their turn can go ahead and pause. Or you can just pause by hitting the rotary button. And now let's go ahead and end the game. And now it's displaying game stats. Our total game time was 1 minute and 1 second. Our playing time happened to also be 1 minute and 1 second because we didn't spend a lot of time paused. There were a total of 4 turns at an average of 15 seconds per turn. Now we can move over to the player stats. And let's go ahead and check out this player's stats, who took the longest amount of time. Bam! He was docked 4 points. He took 2 turns that averaged 23 seconds in length. Now if you remember, the game average was 15 seconds. And then this guy, he took 23 seconds, lost 4 points. This other player, he was actually awarded 10 points because he took 7 seconds on his turn. And the last player should be the same. Yep, oh, actually he took 8 points, but which is still awarding him 10 points. I mean, sorry, he took 8 seconds, which is still awarding him 10 points. All right, and we can go ahead and restart the turn timer. We can keep the same settings if we'd like, or we can go and change some settings. If you keep the same settings, it's just going to ask you to set the turn order all over again, and then you're ready to play. Now we're playing a new game. That's it, guys. Thanks for watching.